Greetings. My name is Mason Brooks, and welcome to this edition of the ActiMotif webinar series. Today, we have a presentation from one of ActiMotif's epigenetic experts, Dr. Sarantis Chlamydas. Sarantis will focus on the epigenetics involved in aging and discuss available tools and strategies for studying that process.
Thank you for being today to my seminar. I will try to explain and to present tools that we use and other labs are using to study epigenetic changes during aging and during age-related disease. I will focus to explain the aging and the connection with epigenetic alterations. I will present you chromatin-related tools in order to study changes during aging, and a DNA methylation assay on cell-free DNA that we have developed internally and we have performed internally in order to study changes on DNA methylation during aging. Here you see the basic mechanism for epigenetic modifications. You will see that we have the DNA methylation at the cytosine, but also we have on chromatin changes for the accessibility, also due to the fact of different personalization modification at the level of histones. Like a readout, we have a differential expression profile that relate with different biological processes and, of course, aging. What we know in regards to aging and epigenetics? We know that during aging, we have accumulation of repetitive elements. We have loss of histones, increase in accumulation of active marks, and decrease in accumulation of repressive marks, and this is leads at the end to the open chromatin. And, of course, specific changes in chromatin states of genes that regulate longevity and immune response, leading to chronic inflammation. In regards to DNA methylation, we and other labs have seen global DNA hypomethylation during aging and a series of biomarkers that they present differential methylation profiles during aging can be really predictive from age. The tools that we and other labs are using are assays based on chromatin accessibility, ataxic and single cell ataxic, and assays based on DNA methylation profiling, something like RRBS, global methylation assays, and MEDIP. This picture shows exactly and very nicely what is going on during aging. We have an open chromatin, and we have an hypertranscription of repetitive elements such as lines or signs. This leads to integration of these repetitive elements to these retrotransposons in different regions in the genome, leading to high rate of mutation and to DNA damage at the end. Here you will see that what's going on during aging from yeast to mammals. Again, retrotransposon elements are again hypomethylated. They are getting more active. This leads to hypertranscription of these elements, DNA damage, and aging effects. Focusing on humans, line 1 signs, they get hypomethylated, and of course, hypertranscription of these repetitive elements again leads to DNA damage and effects of aging and age-related diseases. As I mentioned before, one of the main tools that we use to assess open chromatin accessibility is the ataxic. The protocol has developed originally in 2013, and there's a new version of this protocol in 2016. The way that it works is like once we have the nuclei prepared, we use a transposase that has the sequencing adapters also. By activating the transposase, we have insertion of the adapters at the open chromatin regions. By sequence, we sequence only the open chromatin regions. And this is a nice readout of epigenetic changes during aging. The question is, can we use the chromatin accessibility to assess epigenetic changes or repetitive elements such as lines? The answer from the paper that came out in 2019 is yes. Here you will see really nicely that using different drugs, in that case trichostatin, we are able to assess a differential accessibility of the chromatin on the repeated elements. And this is a really nice assay to assess accessibility of the chromatin during aging and during age-related disease. In case of a complicated sample, like a tissue, in order to have a more precise map of the different subpopulations of the cells, we need to have a protocol that looks at the single cell level. And this is the single cell ataxic, where assess the accessibility of the chromatin at the single cell level. Here you see the experiment of a kidney, the bulk ataxic of a entire tissue, but then when we focus at the single cell, we are able to take different profiles corresponding at different subpopulation of cells. And this is really important because you can focus the treatment, you can focus a precision medicine to specific population of cells when you deal with age-related disease. For DNA methylation studies, we perform and we have it like a service, the RRBS. This is a straightforward protocol. It's focusing on identify differential profiling at the CpG islands. And how does it work? We use specific enzymes that cut inside the CpG islands, and then we profile only CpG islands differential methylation. How can be used? Here I showed you an example of tumor kidney in order to identify biomarkers. You see normal kidney compared to tumor kidney. You will see very nicely that we are able to identify differential methylation profile and potential biomarkers. You can imagine a similar situation when you would like to focus on aging effects. Changing gears, I would like to present you a project that is carried on by our scientist in Carlsbad, Dr. Akanksha Singh. And the scope of this experiment actually is to identify methylation marks during aging using, like an assay, cell-free DNA from serum. In that case, we use two different groups, one from younger females and one from older females, and we perform a series of experiments to identify differential methylation profiling. First, the first assay that Akanksha used actually is the global DNA methylation based on line 1. Why this assay? Because we know line 1 are really abundant in our genome. And there are a lot of studies showing actually a strong correlation of line 1 methylation with global DNA methylation levels. That makes line 1 methylation a really nice biomarker if you want to study changes on DNA methylation during aging. The protocol of this kit is quite simple. It's the genomic digested DNA and biotin-related line 1 probe. We hybridize and then we apply on a 96-well plate. And then with ELISA, this is an ELISA-based assay actually, then using a 5-MC antibody, we are able to recover methylation at the line 1 level. What Akanksha saw is that during aging, there's a drop of DNA methylation at the level of line 1, like expected to be. And of course, this correlates with high rate of DNA damage that we have generated also this type of data, but due to the time, I will not be able to show you today. In order to go be more precise, to identify which regions are differential methylated during aging, we perform the MEDIP experiment. That's quite simple. We have fragmented DNA. We denaturate for 10 minutes at 95 degrees, and then we use a specific antibody against the 5-MC methylation. We pull down, we elaborate preparation, and we are making the sequencing. As a result, we are able to see really nicely that 10% roughly of genes, they are hypomethylating during aging, and 30% they are hypermethylated during aging. And given a closer look, a lot of these genes are involved in immune response, are involved in aging response, in chronic inflammation, so on and so forth, like expected to be. With this, I would like to thank you for your attention, and thanks Active Motif and Akanksha for the nice work that they perform.